Welcome back to Redeemed by Grace Fellowship, kids. It is good to see you. I hope you're ready for a good lesson. Oh, yeah, it's a good one. It is a real big, tall one. Are you ready? Are you sure? Well, we're going to be talking about David and Goliath today. But not just talking about them two. We're going to talk about the Goliaths we have in our life as well. So I hope you're ready for that. But before we get started, what do we need to do? Anybody? That's exactly right. We need to make sure that you ask mom and dad if it's okay if you go down below and hit that subscribe button so that you never, ever miss out on any of our lessons, because you sure wouldn't want to do that, and you sure wouldn't want to get clobbered by a stone, right? That's one way we can kill them giants, right? Well, we'll find out, right? Also, ask mom and dad if it's okay to hit that thumbs up, that like button, because that forces the channel here to share this out to more and more people. That means people on the other side of the world will get to hear about Jesus, all because you hit a thumbs up button. And that is important. That is so important. So make sure that you do that. But make sure you ask mom and dad if you can do that first. Well, again, we're going to look at today how God helps us overcome the giants in our daily lives. We all have big giants out there, don't we? Big, mean old giants that we have to deal with each and every day. And we'll talk about that. But before we do, you know what we ought to do? Let's listen to God tell this story. That's right. Let's listen to the B-I-B-L-E, the Bible, because that's the word for me. Let's hear from God himself as he gives us this story. Good idea? You bet. Well, let me go ahead and bring it up, and you can listen closely. This is a little longer story than we usually do, so I want you to listen closely and see if you hear what happens to this giant. Here we go.
Chapter 17. Now the Philistines gathered their armies for battle, and they were gathered at Soko, which belongs to Judah, and encamped between Soko and Azekah in Ephes-Damon. And Saul and the men of Israel were gathered and encamped in the valley of Elah, and drew up in line of battle against the Philistines. And the Philistines stood on the mountain on the one side, and Israel stood on the mountain on the other side, with a valley between them. And there came out from the camp of the Philistines a champion named Goliath of Gath, whose height was 6 cubits and a span. He had a helmet of bronze on his head, and he was armed with a coat of mail, and the weight of the coat was 5,000 shekels of bronze. And he had bronze armor on his legs, and a javelin of bronze slung between his shoulders. The shaft of his spear was like a weaver's beam, and his spear's head weighed 600 shekels of iron. And his shield-bearer went before him. He stood and shouted to the ranks of Israel, "Why have you come out to draw up for battle? Am I not a Philistine? And are you not servants of Saul? Choose a man for yourselves, and let him come down to me. If he's able to fight with me and kill me, then we will be your servants. But if I prevail against him and kill him, then you shall be our servants and serve us." And the Philistine said, "I defy the ranks of Israel this day. Give me a man that we may fight together." When Saul and all Israel heard these words of the Philistine, they were dismayed and greatly afraid. Now David was the son of an Ephrathite of Bethlehem in Judah, named Jesse, who had 8 sons. In the days of Saul, the man was already old and advanced in years. The 3 oldest sons of Jesse had followed Saul to the battle, and the names of his 3 sons who went to the battle were Eliab the firstborn, and next to him Abinadab, and the 3rd Shema. David was the youngest. The 3 eldest followed Saul. But David went back and forth from Saul to feed his father's sheep at Bethlehem. For 40 days the Philistine came forward and took his stand, morning and evening, And Jesse said to David his son, take for your brothers an ephah of this parched grain and these 10 loaves, and carry them quickly to the camp to your brothers. Also take these 10 cheeses to the commander of their 1,000. See if your brothers are well, and bring some token from them. Now Saul and they and all the men of Israel were in the valley of Elah, fighting with the Philistines. And David rose early in the morning and left the sheep with a keeper, and took the provisions and went as Jesse had commanded him. And he came to the encampment as the host was going out to the battle line, shouting the war cry. And Israel and the Philistines drew up for battle, army against army. And David left the things in charge of the keeper of the baggage and ran to the ranks and went and greeted his brothers. As he talked with them, behold, the champion, the Philistine of Gath, Goliath by name, came up out of the ranks of the Philistines and spoke the same words as before, and David heard him. All the men of Israel, when they saw the man, fled from him and were much afraid. And the men of Israel said, have you seen this man who has come up? Surely he has come up to defy Israel, and the king will enrich the man who kills him with great riches and will give him his daughter and make his father's house free in Israel. And David said to the man who stood by him, what shall be done for the man who kills this Philistine and takes away the reproach from Israel? For who is this uncircumcised Philistine that he should defy the armies of the living God? And the people answered him in the same way, so shall it be done to the man who kills him. Now Eliab, his eldest brother, heard when he spoke to the men. And Eliab's anger was kindled against David, and he said, why have you come down, and with whom have you left those few sheep in the wilderness? I know your presumption and the evil of your heart, for you have come down to see the battle. And David said, what have I done now? Was it not but a word? And he turned away from him toward another and spoke in the same way, and the people answered him again as before. When the words that David spoke were heard, they repeated them before Saul, and he sent for him. And David said to Saul, let no man's heart fail because of him. Your servant will go and fight with this Philistine. And Saul said to David, you are not able to go against this Philistine to fight with him, for you are but a youth, and he has been a man of war from his youth. But David said to Saul, your servant used to keep sheep for his father, and when there came a lion or a bear and took a lamb from the flock, I went after him and struck him and delivered it out of his mouth. And if he arose against me, I caught him by his beard and struck him and killed him. Your servant has struck down both lions and bears, and this uncircumcised Philistine shall be like one of them, for he has defied the armies of the living God. And David said, the Lord who delivered me from the paw of the lion and from the paw of the bear will deliver me from the hand of this Philistine. And Saul said to David, go, and the Lord be with you. Then Saul clothed David with his armor. He put a helmet of bronze on his head and clothed him with a coat of mail, and David strapped his sword over his armor. And he tried in vain to go, for he had not tested them. Then David said to Saul, I cannot go with these, for I have not tested them. So David put them off. Then he took his staff in his hand and chose 5 smooth stones from the brook and put them in his shepherd's pouch. His sling was in his hand, and he approached the Philistine. And the Philistine moved forward and came near to David with his shield bearer in front of him. And when the Philistine looked and saw David, he disdained him, for he was but a youth, ruddy and handsome in appearance. And the Philistine said to David, am I a dog that you come to me with sticks? And the Philistine cursed David by his gods. The Philistine said to David, come to me, and I will give your flesh to the birds of the air and to the beasts of the field. Then David said to the Philistine, you come to me with a sword and with a spear and with a javelin, but I come to you in the name of the Lord of hosts, the God of the armies of Israel, whom you have defied. This day the Lord will deliver you into my hand, and I will strike you down and cut off your head, and I will give the dead bodies of the host of the Philistines this day to the birds of the air and to the wild beasts of the earth, that all the earth may know that there is a God in Israel, and that all this assembly may know that the Lord saves not with sword and spear, for the battle is the Lord's, and he will give you into our hand. When the Philistine arose and came and drew near to meet David, David ran quickly toward the battle line to meet the Philistine. And David put his hand in his bag and took out a stone and slung it and struck the Philistine on his forehead. The stone sank into his forehead, and he fell on his face to the ground.
Wow, that's a pretty neat story, isn't it? It sure is. That's pretty scary, too, going up against that giant, right? You know, he's pretty tall. You know, real tall. Real tall. Absolutely. Well, let's watch our video and let's see if we can get an idea of what he looks like, this giant. You ready? Pay close attention. Here we go.
Hello. Hello down there. Oh, that's right. You can't see me from there. That's better. Sorry, it's really hard for me to fit in the whole screen because, well, I'm a giant. Where are my manners? Let me introduce myself. My name is Goliath. Yeah, I'm the bad guy from the Bible. I was one big, tall, mean dude. But I'm not here to be mean or to fight you. I'm here to talk to you about everyday giants.
Hmm?
Everyday giants. Where can I start? Well, the chances are, God isn't going to call you to fight a Philistine giant like me. But you do fight giants every day. Do you know that? Let me just give you some examples. Worry. You may not see this first one as a giant, but it's something we can all face, and it can seem like a giant. To get rid of worry, you need God's help. Oh, and what about fear? I thought David would be afraid of me, but he wasn't. He said that God would help him win, and God did. Here's another example of a giant. Sickness. Maybe you or someone you love is really sick. That can seem like a giant. God can help you as you face the giant of sickness. Oh, I know a little bit about this next giant. Bullies. Yeah, I was a big old bully. And yet, God gave David what he needed to knock me out. One last thing before I go. If you're having a hard time with an everyday giant, take it from a giant like me. God is bigger than any giant you will ever face.
God is bigger than any giant you'll ever face. Boy, that's comforting, isn't it? Yeah. Well, can you guess what I have in this bag? That's a pretty good guess. Yeah, I have a whole bunch of things in here. You know what I've got in here? Let me pull them out for you. Let me get them. Oops, I almost dropped one. Okay. I have 5 stones. 5 stones. 2. Count them with me. 3, 4, and 5. I got 5 stones in my bag. Now my bag's empty. It's all empty now. Put that up there for now. Well, of course you know about the boy named David, and you surely know about the giant. You surely know about Goliath, the big bad giant. And and when we saw him, this boy fought and killed the giant. Can you believe that? A boy fought and killed the giant named Goliath. Now, Goliath was a mighty warrior, and he was more than 9 feet tall. You know how tall that is? Can anyone show me how tall that is? Well, that's a pretty good idea. I got this out. Good old tape measure. Oh, I'm still going up. I haven't got there yet. Oh, I hit the roof. Oh, no. All the way to the floor. Wow, that's almost 9.5 feet up there. That only leaves him about this much space without banging his head on my ceiling. That's pretty tall, isn't it? That's bigger than most of our Christmas trees. And some of those can be pretty big sometimes, right? Yeah. Yeah. So he is big and tall, but not only that. Not only that. But Goliath was also, he also wore real strong armor so he couldn't get hurt. Strong armor on his whole body, and he had a sword and a spear, and the armor weighed about 100 pounds. I don't know about you, you put that, I don't know if I could even move. That's pretty heavy, isn't it? But no problem for this big old giant, right? Yeah, it weighed about 100 pounds, and it probably weighed more than each one of you, right? Yeah, it's exactly. Now, David, on the other hand, was a young shepherd boy, and he had no armor. I mean, it was too heavy for him, and he had no sword or spear either. I mean, David's weapon was a slingshot, and all the ammunition he had was 5 stones in a bag. That's it. All he had, and he picked those up from a nearby stream, as we heard in our Bible reading. But David defeated the giant, who the entire country, all the Israelite soldiers, they were afraid to face him because of how enormous he was and strong he was. They didn't, but he did. He did. You know, I was thinking, we might not face a 9-foot giant, but we face giants of other kinds, don't we? All kinds of things. Oh, yeah, I can give you an example. How about like insecurity? Yeah, that's a big one. Or loneliness. You ever been lonely? Me too. Me too. We fight that giant all the time. Or failure, where we just can't get it right. We face that giant a lot. And we can remember when we get in those situations, we can remember David's 5 stones to help us. 5 stones to help us defeat the giant. Well, let me tell you about these stones. This first stone, it represents courage. David wasn't afraid to face the enemy. In fact, in the Bible lesson, in 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 32, he said, "Don't worry about a thing." And that's what he said to Saul, the king. "And I will go fight this Philistine." I mean, you will use courage to face giants all your life. And where do we get that courage? Well, we'll think about that. But you know, this one, it represents confidence. And as a shepherd, David protected the sheep from wild animals. You remember that in the Bible lesson? Absolutely. So he had confidence to face Goliath. "The Lord who saved me from the claws of the lion and bear will save me from this Philistine, he said. Remember that? And like David, you can have confidence that God will help you overcome the problems you face. Absolutely. Well, this next stone, the third one here, it represents preparation. Now, David didn't face the giant unprepared. He went to the stream and he collected these five stones in his bag. And armed with the shepherd's staff, that's just a piece of wood, like a cane, right? Or walking stick, all right? And so with that shepherd's staff and a slingshot, he went to fight Goliath. And it's important that you and I prepare to face the challenges that we're going to meet in life too, to face those giants that we have in our life. And how do we do that? Well, one of you got one of them. That's right, the B-I-B-L-E. We need to read our Bible and to understand God's word and his plan for us so that we know what God wants in our life. And the other one is, I'll give you a hint. Yeah, okay, you got it, prayer. That's right, we need to spend time with God, talking to God, learning and praying. Learning and praying goes together. Yeah, it's an important thing. It's an important thing. Well, this fourth stone here, it represents something very important. Trust. Now, David didn't trust his own ability. He was too smart for that. Goliath is over 9 feet tall, big and strong. He was strong enough to still be able to move when he had 100 pounds armor on him. And so he knew that he could not match up to him. He did not. But when Goliath shouted at David and cursed him and was ready to kill him, David said, "You come to me with your sword and spear, but I come to you in the name of the Lord God Almighty." I'm trusting in the Lord God Almighty to win this battle. And all I'm going to do is trust that he's going to take care of it. That he will take care of it. And so we need to, when we face problems, we need to put our trust in God and not in our own ability, because our own ability is not of God. Let's face it, there's no giant out there that's too big for God. And Goliath even said so in the video, didn't he? He sure did. He knows his match. Well, this fifth stone, this last one, it represents victory. Victory. It's God's battle, not ours, David said. That's why David had victory over the giant with only a stone and a sling. Friends, when we turn our battles over to God, you'll have victory over the giants in your life. And how do we get victory? Look on that stone. Do you see that? That's right, it's a cross. That reminds us of Jesus Christ. For our enemy was death because of her sin. And Jesus conquered it that you and I might live for always with him, for eternity. Isn't that pretty cool? So it's important for us to have courage in the Lord. It's important for us to have confidence in the Lord. We need to put in that preparation by reading our Bible and praying to God every day. If you don't know how to read, ask somebody to read it to you so that you are prepared to trust that God will take care of it. You don't have to do the battle. He will. Put your trust in him and celebrate the victory that Jesus has given us to even be able to talk to God. It's so powerful, isn't it? So powerful. So the next time you're facing a giant in your life, remember David and Goliath and these five stones. Courage, confidence, preparation, trust, and victory through Jesus Christ our Lord. Isn't that neat? And can you say those words? Repeat it with me. I'll hold it up. That's right. That's right. Courage. Got the first one. Here's the next one. Confidence. Yeah, good, good. How about this one? That's right. Bible and prayer. That's called preparation. Preparation's the word. Good job. How about this one? You bet. Trust. Trust. Believe and have faith in the Lord Jesus Christ and that he will deliver. What will he deliver? The fifth stone. That's right. The victory. The victory over the giants in your life. Let's pray together. Pray with me. Dear God, just as you gave David the victory in his battle with Goliath, we know that when we put our trust in you, you will give us the victory over giants, the giants that we face in our daily lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen and amen. I told you it was going to be a good lesson. We got another good one coming up next week. That's right. Next week, we're going to be talking about that there's power in a touch. We're going to look at, see how powerful Jesus really is. Because there's power in a touch. And we're going to be looking at the Gospel of Mark in chapter 5 and verses 21 through 43. So if you get a chance to read that in your Bible, do so. Or if you can have mom and dad read it to you, that would be great too. But yeah, absolutely. Well, kids, we've had fun today. This has been a great lesson, and we know now how we can beat the giants. So now it's time for us to start our preparation. So it's time to get up on our feet, get ready to march into battle, singing about the B-I-B-L-E-Y. Because that's the book for me. Kids, know that we love you, and we will see you next week. Get ready to march. One, two, three, march.